having any commitment, any monogamy. It's been pushed on us and it's been bombarded through the media and through every outlet possible in our minds where friends with benefits is considered normal. And I'm talking about within the Christian community. That's considered a norm. It's to the point now where women aren't even looking for relationships because most men don't want to be in a relationship. Or they say they do, and then they're dishonest, lying, and cheating. So over time, that has caused women to kind of throw their hands up in the air and be like, forget it. What's the use of me giving my heart to people and giving my heart to men and giving my body to them, and I can't even receive commitment from them. They're not giving me their heart back. And so over time, it has created this new norm within our community. And it's bad, and I'm just being real, you know. I've been there, done that, everything that you probably could think of, I've been through, and I've done, and I took from that, and I learned from my experiences. Bad experiences and mistakes aren't bad unless you don't learn from them, and I learned from them. So, you know, again, I say it's not normal. A man should respect you. Make him respect you. If you don't make a man respect you, he's going to continue to disrespect you. I've let men know, even men that I know work in the grocery store, and I see them every time I go shopping. If you or AAA at me, I'm going to let you know I'm a lady. Don't address me like that. And if you do it, I'm going to act like I don't even hear you. You're not even on my radar because you're disrespectful out top. So why would I even give attention to that? You invisible to me now because I told you and you still not respecting me. But if I talk to him and he's respectful off the top, out the gate, then our relationship is already founded on disrespect and it's going to continue that way. That man is not going to change the way he treats you. So you never let a man disrespect you. And some men look for women that have low self-esteem and that don't know their worth because they have a predator mentality. There are men that use women for money. There are men that use women for sex. I mean, it is what it is and it's what happens. And I can't speak for anybody else, but I know I've done it all. And I'm in a place right now where I see at the end of the day, the only person that's going to be there, the only person that's going to always keep it real, the only person that's always dependable, really not even a person, but it's God. I don't care who you are, what you believe in, and whether or not you can debate with me or disagree with me, but it is what it is. God was the only person that was there at the time where I needed somebody the most. And I'm sure a lot of other you can say the exact same thing. Am I right? So what's the point in me putting myself out there like that? Now, I have made mistakes. I'm not perfect, but the only time that it even gets to a point of intimacy is if I actually have feelings for that person. That don't make it right. It's still fornication. It's still wrong. I'm not gonna call myself a Christian, and I ain't even trying to live like one. So as long as your heart intention is to do the right thing, a good man will come. A good man definitely will come, but you have to make sure that your bait is correct so he'll step correct. All right. Well, you know, I know I'm going to get a lot of comments. I can't wait to hear what people have to say about this. And like I said again, most women, they've been hurt so many times to where they pretty much gave up on looking for love. And so they settle and they compromise and accept the friend with benefits thing just to have somebody to hold them, just to not be lonely, just to have comfort, especially women that have went through divorce or really bad breakups or heartbreak. And sometimes just those few minutes of having someone hold you, having someone caress you, having someone show that affection, sometimes that's enough for a woman to compromise her moral beliefs and her standards just to have that temporary satisfaction. And I completely understand. I've been there. Women that have been hurt, you know, a lot of times we become a product of our past relationships. And at that point, we have to heal from that and move forward so that we can attract a man that will treat us right, that will not disrespect us. And just because a man asks for sex and you're not married, even though he's a Christian and you are, doesn't mean he doesn't care about you or love you. It only means that they're human. But there are red flags and there are signs that that's the only thing a guy wants out of you. And those red flags or signs are a time of day that he calls you. What's the first thing he say to you when he call you? Does the conversation always center around sex? Is the only time you get alone is in the bedroom? A lot of these are signs that sex is the only thing that he wants from you and out of you. Also, disrespect is the number one sign. If he doesn't respect you or respect your feelings, then they let you know that that's all you are to him. You know, you're just somebody for him to have sex with, you know, when he get bored, and that's it. No commitment, no strings attached. And I just think it makes you less of a man that you would even treat a woman like that, because for you men that are fathers, you don't want your daughters being treated like that. So at least be real with her if that's what it is. And as I said again, it doesn't mean he doesn't love you. It just means he's human. And if you have chemistry and you're attracted to each other, this is what's going to happen and what it's going to lead to. So the decision you make is, you know, dependent on you. And there are people that are happily married that had sex before they got married, and they have a really good marriage. God still has blessed their marriage, that they took the vows that they take before God. And I mean, they've been married 20 plus years, happy. So this is not a cookie cutter thing in general, and it's like this for every single person. But in a broad aspect, for the most part, this is how it works. So women, look for the signs. If you feel like you're being used and that's the only thing he's interested in, if you're miserable, it makes no sense to keep doing it. It's no point. And if he hasn't gave God his heart, it's no point in giving yourself to him, because he's not going to even know how to take care of you or what to do with it. And like my mom always told me, you can't get blood out of a turnip. You can't get love out of a man that isn't ready to love, or doesn't know how to love, or doesn't want to. You know, it's either one of the three. And a lot of men don't want to, because so many women have gave up and they have sex without any type of monogamy. They don't even ask, well, have you had sex with anybody else, and when, and was it unprotected? Some women just go right into it and don't even ask those questions. You know, and it's either that, and it's not always because she's a freak or she a hoe. Sometimes it's out of loneliness. Sometimes it's out of heartbreak. You know, that this woman, if this is what it takes for her to get some affection, for her not to feel lonely, for her to feel desired, then sometimes you're willing to gamble that and compromise. So I'm just speaking the truth. It is what it is. Sound off. Let me know what you think. I can't wait. And especially to me, and I want to hear what you got to say. But I can tell you one thing. Ladies out there that's looking for a good man, your body type is not the most important thing. You know, how pretty you are, none of those things, those aren't the most important things, and they do matter. There has to be attraction. But confidence is the best asset. Confidence is the best accessory. Confidence is what attracts a man. Whether you're a size 2 or a size 12, if you're confident, if you have high self-esteem about yourself, not arrogant and big-headed, but confident, if you're comfortable in who you are, he's going to be comfortable with who you are. If you're comfortable with your size, he's going to be comfortable with your size. And that's a whole nother subject. So ladies, love yourself, because if you don't, nobody else is going to love you. All right. Well, I can't wait to hear what you got to say about it. And I'm going to holler at y'all later.